Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, that is Mechanical Engineering. Today in this video we are going to discuss the differences between bolt and screw. So sometimes we may have confusion between the bolt and screw, that's why I have chosen these topics, and in this video we are going to discuss few differences in between the bolt and the screw. So for differentiating bolt and screw, I have made two different columns. The first column is for bolt and the second column is for screw. And again I have added two images below the point so as to clear the point very clearly in a better manner. So the very first difference between the bolt and screw is, a bolt is an externally threaded fastener designed for insertion through the holes in assemble parts and is normally intended to be a tightened or released by torquing a nut. So basically bolt is nothing but a fastener which is basically used for fastening the things, and it is used with the nut. And how it is clamped? It is clamped by giving the torque to the nut or to the bolt. Then the screw. A screw is an externally threaded fastener capable of being inserted into the holes in assemble parts of mating with a perform internal threads or forming its own thread, and of being tightened or released by torquing the head. So screw is also a type of fastener. Okay, and it is capable of being inserted into the holes in assemble parts. So we can insert the screw into the hole, or it may produce its own hole with the help of threads which is present externally over it. And how it is clamped? It is clamped by giving the torque to its head. Okay, so this is the first difference. Then second difference, the bolt have generally uniform cross section. So here you can see the first image, that is nothing but bolt, and it has a uniform cross section. Now the screw generally have non-uniform cross section. So here in second image you can see the image of screw, and it has non-uniform cross section. Third difference, the bolt are always used with the nut. So nut is always used with the bolt for assembly purpose, we can say. Then screw, it is not used with the nut but used alone. So screw is used alone, the bolt is not necessary. Then the next difference, the threads on the bolt are spiral in structure. So here you can see the threads on the bolt, they are spiral in structure or spiral in shape, whereas the threads on the screw are helical in structure. So the threads on the screw are helical in structure. Next difference, it does not have tapered shank. So the bolt does not have tapered shank. So here you can see the nomenclature of the bolt. So the threaded portion, then the nut over the bolt, thread length, then the shank, radius and the head. So the bolt does not have tapered shank. So here you can see the shank do not have any taper. Okay, whereas in screw, it has a tapered or pointed shank. So screw has tapered or pointed shank. Here in this image you cannot see the tapered shank, but most of the screw has a tapered shank. Next difference, bolt mostly requires wrenches and spanner for tightening and loosening purpose. So for tightening and loosening purpose we have to use either spanner or wrench in case of bolt. Now the screw requires mostly screwdrivers for tightening and loosening purpose. So here you can see various screws and the screwdriver. So mostly screwdriver is required for tightening and loosening purpose in case of screw. Next difference, the parts that are joined together with the bolt have greater strength than screw. So whenever the assembly is done with the help of bolt, it has a better strength as compared to the assembly which is done by screw. Okay, so the parts that are joined together with the bolts have greater strength than the screw. Now in case of screw, the parts joined together with the screw have less strength than the bolt. So when we compare the parts which are assembled together with the screw and the parts which are assembled together with the bolt. So the parts which are assembled together with the screw has less strength. Okay, here I have shown the failure of bolt. So mostly the bolts are subjected under tensile strength, tensile stress, and due to which it gets failed. How it is failed? It is broken down into two pieces, and this is nothing but failure of screw. The next point, the bolts are more reliable. The screws are less reliable. Okay. The next point, the bolt apply compression on the parts that they join. So here you can see in the image. So for clamping the bolt, the torque is applied with the help of spanner, and when we are clamping the parts, okay, so it applies a compressive stresses over that part, and the bolt is subjected to tensile stress. Okay, so whenever the assembly is done with the help of nut and bolt, that assembly is under compression due to the applied torque, whereas the bolt is under tension. Then in case of screw, the screw don't apply compression on the parts that they join. So here, simply with the help of screwdriver, we can assemble the parts together, and it do not apply any compressive force over that part. The next part, difference, the parts that are to be joined with the bolt must have holes for the insertion. So whenever we want to join the part with the help of nut and bolt, so the part should have a previously drilled hole, then and then we can join those part with the help of nut and bolt. Then in case of screw, holes may or may not be required in the parts which are to be joined with the screw. In most of the cases, it is directly screwed into the part to be joined. So the holes may or may not be required. If there is a hole, it is well and good. And even if there is not, even if there is no any hole over the part, we can assemble that part with the help of screw directly. So simply with the help of screwdriver, we can apply the force as the end of the screw is pointed. So it is easily get penetrated inside the part. Okay, so holes may or may not be required whenever the parts are joined together with the help of screw. And the last point, the various examples of bolt and screw. So the examples of bolt are anchor bolt, carriage bolt, elevator bolt, flange bolt, hanger bolt, hexagon bolt, lag bolt, machine bolt, plow bolt, sex bolt, shoulder bolt, square head bolt, stud bolt, timber bolt, T-head bolt, toggle bolt, U-bolt, J-bolt, I-bolt. These are nothing but different types of bolts. Whereas the different types of screws are wood screw, machine screw, thread cutting machine screw, sheet metal screw, self-driving screw, socket screw, I-lack screw, mating screw, set screw, etc. So these are nothing but different types of bolt and screw. So thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.